Looking after yourself is just as important as looking after your baby. It's a busy time looking after your baby, feeding, changing, and everything else that goes with it. And sometimes it seems like there's no time for yourself, your partner, or the rest of your family.
Having young baby, it's the sleep deprivation, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's definitely the lack of sleep is the hardest thing to adjust to. We went from 9 hours a night to two in a row, maybe.
Two at most.
Most. That's definitely the hardest thing to get used to.
At the start, it was definitely, it was exhausting because you have to be there and be functional 24/7.
You can feel quite isolated if you don't see people or get out. Like, I really looked forward to Jim getting home at 6 or 7 because you just crave that sort of adult company, but you also need a bit of a break. You need to be able to hand them over.
Basically, trying to incorporate my exercise, you know, I was quite keen to get back into exercise after she was born, and so it was it was quite difficult to do that.
So amongst everything else that's going on, make sure you take a bit of time out for yourself, because healthy mum and dad makes a healthy home.
Busy day, eh?
Yeah, look after each other, and when grandparents offer to babysit, take it.
Yeah.
You know, it was really good for us to have some us time again.
Quite important.
Once Olivia was at the stage where I could actually take her out for a couple of hours, then I made sure I actually did get out and do something, you know, even if it's just going to the mall or walking, you know, 500 metres up the road to get an ice cream, you know, at least something to get me out of the house. Yeah.
Well, we initially had a date night
one day a week,
hey, which I think I need to resurrect because that helped us get away from everything and, you know, be ourselves.
It's just making the time to have a meal together or having your evenings together. I mean, it may just be a snippet of an evening, but when you've got the time, sitting down together.
Caring for your child is a joy most of the time, but make sure you use the support you have out there. It can make the job of being a parent much easier. Talk with your partner about any problems you're having. You may also want to join a parents group or talk to your health professional, family and friends. All these people are a wealth of support, so don't forget to use them.
I think the support that we got from our families initially was fantastic.
Yep,
Safita's mum's a real baby person, so she's really naturally good with babies, I think, so that was really great.
So I guess with our support for Tana, obviously we're there for each other, but I also, through our antenatal class, we had a coffee group. So we used to meet up quite regularly, and we don't meet up as much now, but that was a support group for me.
I found a creche at the gym where I go to, and we could start her in that after she was 3 months. So I went in the first time and sat with her through that, and she seemed to be, they were really good in there, and she seemed to quite enjoy it. So then the next time we went in, I left her there in the creche, and that's worked quite well.
Yes, I've officially quit my job, so plans are to be the stay-home dad and sole caregiver, I suppose, of Olivia for a good 8 hours, eh?
But it'll be so nice having, you know, a parent at home looking after you the whole day, so I can go out there and earn the money.
Throughout this DVD, we've talked about feeding your child, but there's someone else who needs good, nutritious food, and that's you. It's important to eat regular nourishing meals to maintain your energy levels over the day, because you'll surely need it. You probably need to snack in between your meals too, especially if you're breastfeeding. Choose healthy alternatives such as sandwiches and fruit, yogurt and fruit smoothies, cheese and crackers. Remember, skipping meals will not help you lose weight. It will just make you feel tired.
I think it's so important to remember to eat and drink, because that is really easy to forget. And especially with breastfeeding, you need to be drinking as much water as you can. And I found that I could go hours with forgetting to eat or drink, but I really tried to remember myself whenever I could and just carry a bottle of water with me at all times. That's really important.
But I had a lot of Complan, which was really, really good. But then it's just making sure that you are actually taking time to feed yourself properly. So, you know, it's having a really good breakfast, making sure you're having vegetables and a decent meat at night, really.
Listen to your body. If you feel hungry, it's time to eat. Make sure you drink plenty as well. Your body does need extra water and energy to keep up your breast milk supply. It's a good idea to have a drink whenever you breastfeed. Try a glass of water, milk, or diluted juice. If you need extra energy, you could try a supplement drink like Complan.
We've got a healthy mum's guide, which you can find on our website, forbaby.co.nz.
Seek help from a health professional if you're having ongoing physical pain or problems with breastfeeding, or if your mood is persistently low, you're overtired and exhausted, and this is affecting your ability to care for yourself and baby. If you have concerns, see your midwife, Plunket nurse, well child provider, lactation consultant, or GP.
So remember, look after yourself, rest when you can, ask for help when you need it, eat well and drink plenty of fluids. If you're feeling unwell, please see your health professional.